What's up, ladies and gentlemen of the interweb? So, I'm a little late on this, but recently we got some major news on the Resident Evil 2 remake, or should I say, Resident Evil 2 reimagining, which made me hugely excited, like Jesus Christ coming back and I'm a grandma in the Appalachian Mountains kind of levels of excitement. That's how excited I was. So the Resident Evil 2 news is that the story is going to be different. Like, it's gonna stay true to the original, but in a new way, and with added twists and new stuff to make it very much a new game, not just a remake or a remaster, but a completely new game. So imagine Prey 2017. This is a completely different game, but, I mean, that game, it was the worst reboot of all time, don't get me wrong, but it took Prey 2006's story and turned it into something new and different from the original, but still stayed true to the basic premises of the series. So in Resident Evil 2, there's going to be a lot that is different. And they have said that the people who have played the game one time or a thousand times will have no easy experience because, unlike most remasters and remakes, this game is 100% different. It just follows the same general story. So I guess, you know, when we play this game, it's going to be a new game. It's not just, you know, your everyday remake or remaster. It's going to be a completely different game, remade from the ground up, with a somewhat similar story, but with a story being told in a different way, and with different plot twists and all this, that, and the other, which, I'm going to be completely honest with you, that gives me hope. That kind of gives me hope for the Resident Evil series. So, let's have a little bit of history with Resident Evil right quick. Historically, the best Resident Evil games, or games that launched on a Nintendo platform as an exclusive, and historically the worst ones are the ones that did not launch exclusively on a Nintendo platform. So, this means this game might be the first main series Resident Evil to not launch on Nintendo that might actually stand the test of time. So when I say that, think about this: Resident Evil 0, Resident Evil Revelations, Resident Evil 4, and all these countless other games, they launched on Nintendo exclusively. But since they were launched and made for a Nintendo system, Capcom felt a higher production quality was needed. Because Nintendo is quality, PlayStation and Xbox are bloatware. So they saw that and they made those games classics. I mean, look at Resident Evil 5, 6, and the rest of them. They aren't going to be remembered in 15 years. And in 15 years, those games are not going to be ported to 10 million different things. But you know what will still be getting ports in 15 years? Resident Evil 4, Resident Evil 0, Resident Evil Revelations. And you know, even let's take it a step further, the remaster for the first Resident Evil was a Nintendo GameCube exclusive, and it's been ported 10 million times. So I really, really have some huge hope that this might be the first Resident Evil that is not a Nintendo exclusive that ends up, you know, standing the test of time and being an absolutely huge game. I mean, they're all huge games, but this might be the one, you know, the one that sets Resident Evil off of Nintendo away from the ones that were made exclusively for Nintendo, if that makes sense. But, you know, that's just my opinion. With that being said, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for all future Resident Evil news. And my name is CRUZANDO, try not to die, and I'll see you in the next video.